Hi there, my name is Scott Phillips. I'm the president and founder of StarFish Medical, and today we're going to be talking about standards, how to comply with standards in the implementation of your medical device. Now, a lot of people see standards as bureaucratic obstacles. What is the least thing we could do and call it ISO compliant? And my belief is that you're actually selling yourself short if you go out with that approach. These standards are the condensed wisdom, to some extent, of 100 years of industrial practice, and they don't specifically apply just to medical. For example, ISO 13485, which is very similar to the US QSR, or under the Code of Federal Regulations, basically says how to run your company. It says, here's how you design by setting specifications and requirements and thinking about risks, and then testing to show that your device meets the specifications, and then making sure users have a chance to use it and confirm that it meets their need, or if there's clinical data required, that there's standards for that. These are just the basics of doing a good job, and they're going to save you a whole lot of trouble. When you get to the manufacturing side, the standards require things like that you've figured out who your vendors are, and you've made sure that you're satisfied that they will produce high quality product. You've inspected the things that come to you and that they're the right things and that they're used in your device in standard ways, and those are documented. Any changes are documented. And there's a few other bits and pieces to do corrective and preventive actions and so on. But really, these are just how to run a company well, and it's a shortcut. I know in our company, the fact that we implemented those systems very early on, I feel was one of the enabling pieces that allowed us to scale rapidly to about 20 people and not break in the process. So I'm highly supportive of implementing wise systems based on the requirements. And I believe that if you have the attitude that these are useful, important building blocks of a good company, it will lead you down a different path. One of the elements I'd like to talk to you about is ISO zealots. Now, certain people in the world are wired to want everything organized and everything perfect. And very often, these are the people who are attracted to roles as quality management. And I think that while that attitude is very useful and important, it's not something you want to put in charge of organizing your company, because it'll snarl the whole thing up. I talked about wisdom. How do you implement things that are done sensibly, usefully, but allow the creativity to still flourish in the right spots. You don't design a device by laying out exactly what it is and sort of pre-designing it. You design it by thinking creatively and figuring it out. And as you go, you're able to flesh out the requirements. And then as you sort of wrap up the creative part, you're able to define the specifications and how you're going to test to show that they work. It's really a lighter touch at the earlier stage, followed by the more heavy-duty process towards the end. Risk analysis should be thought of early. That will allow you to make sure you think of the downside as well. How might this thing fail to operate? Make sure that you show that you incorporate those mitigations into the development process as well. One extra element I wanted to talk about today is gate reviews. These are not specifically mandated by the ISO process or by the FDA, but in my experience, it's critical to do this well in order to design a good product. It will really save you from misalignment, where certain people in your team, or management, or an investor may have the idea that you're pushing towards production, but the engineers still know that you're working on some critical proof of concept items. But if you have a gate that you either pass or don't pass to get to the proof of concept, for example, you won't be allowed. You won't allow yourself to think that you're just about in manufacturing if you still have some elements of the core concept that have not been adequately demonstrated or shown to be manufacturable or some critical thing like that. Forcing yourself to ask the right question at the critical moments, and in my view, the moments are at the proof of concept gate, at the alpha prototype gate, where you have your full integrated system for the first time. That may not be 100%, but it shows all the pieces. At the beta gate, where you now have something that's designed using the right manufactured parts and designed for regular, for radio frequency compliance, etc. and at the manufacturing transfer gate. If you get good, mature questions asked at those points, you will have a lot higher likelihood of having a good outcome. So, to wrap it all up, I highly support implementing ISO well and wisely and the other complementary standards that apply to your device. You'll find it makes your company better. Add a gate review. Make sure the quality person you have in your company can think a little more broadly than a super precise detail person, and you'll do a great job. If you need any support with any of these things, we'd be happy to help. Thanks.